De zaken die wij doen, is het beter om maar anoniem te blijven.
Maar ik hou van towncars.
Sorry.
Time. The fuck with me! Open it! Open it! I'll call my broker.
I'm just saying, that's all.
Whatever. Take off your coat!
Mister, I thought I told...
Got balls, but no positive identification.
Nah, there's another camera pointing at the platform.
Michael, stop it right there.
You see what I see?
Maybe.
That's him, Lieutenant.
That's who?
How long have you been a detective, Michaels?
11 months, sir.
I'm 22 years in robbery and homicide. One of your subcategories of robbery is art theft. There's a lot of that in the Apple. Are you aware of that, Michaels?
I guess so. Yeah.
I wasn't. When I was your age, I was quite happy with regular murder and mayhem.
Lieutenant Weber minored in art history at Fordham.
Anyway, the chief starts calling me Lieutenant Picasso and puts me in charge every time there is the theft of as much as an etch-a-sketch. 2 decades, I've been putting them all away. Everybody but him, Keith Ripley. He's the best there is. Howdy, Keith.
Been bad boy. Perhaps I could give you 50.
No. That is not possible.
I wouldn't take less than 100. I'm just saying is all.
You.
Mind if I borrow this?
Well, I may have wanted to use it.
But yours could do.
Will you please put down my gun?
That's one thing you should be aware of, Gabriel. Or do you prefer Signor Martini? The police cannot arrest you for armed robbery if your gun isn't loaded.
Your point?
You think I'd walk around with a loaded shotgun?
Let's see.
You could have checked.
Why? You have my diamonds, my score, my money. Enjoy. Nice meeting you both. Bye. By the way, I was going to ask for 125. I am just saying, it's all.
Gabrielle, stay.
Why? What else do you want? You gonna shoot me now?
Well, inasmuch as you did steal the diamonds, I figure it's only fair to share the proceeds with you.
So to what do I owe this act of generosity?
I have a proposition I wish to discuss with you.
So, how did you know I would come here? As well as my name.
It's part of the proposition.
Come on!
All right, take it easy. Take it easy.
Nick would like his money.
Ask him.
Thank you. This is something between you and them. You have nothing to do with me.
Everything does now. Call this interest. Nick is tired of waiting for you. Especially.
You must have very bad karma.
Actually, don't believe in it. Look, about this problem.
No. You are totally out of your mind. Good night.
Hey.
What?
Here's your karma.
What was in the other envelope?
Your cut. Now you got mine. Think about it.
Yeah, sure.
What do you think I was doing on that train? I was watching your work. I've been your shadow ever since you got to town. So why were you in my town robbing subways?
It's hurricane season in Miami. I don't like hurricanes.
Or you didn't feel like going back to Angola.
It's over. Lesson learned.
Look, Gabriel Martin is a rock star, so why were you holding open mic night on the subway for a lousy $100,000?
Two reasons. Yes, Miami was getting too hot. And perhaps you can relate to this. Sometimes you just need to feel the rush. The juice. Yeah. You know what I mean.
Yesterday, you took down two jewelers for a few stone from Romanov's. My idea is Romanov's itself.
Please.
Specifically, two Fabergé eggs worth $20 million. Each. It's a two-man job. Do I have your attention?
Wait here.
I hear they prefer cash. On your firstborn.
Why don't you try the standard instead? Jealous?
Of who?
The mystery bandit.
I'm afraid that type of thing is not my style.
Well, I think this guy's got panache. Guts. And a passing resemblance, at least in body type.
Well, you don't have to rob trains to have panache.
Or guts. But you got to admit, that kind of thing immediately brands you. Привет, Миша. Спасибо. My treat. Too painful watching you attempt to read Cyrillic.
Oh, no. I was just looking at the picture.
So you are jealous?
Yes. You got me there. Absolutely.
I gotta get this Chinese food to my boss, so, some other time.
When? Some other time?
I'll call you.
Well, you don't have my number or know my name or anything.
Well, I guess that could be a problem.
Gabrielle!
Oh, shit.
Are you with him?
I don't know. Should I? More or less.
Yes, I am.
What do you want?
Can I bring my goddaughter a birthday present?
My birthday was last month.
It was 2 weeks ago. And I'm sorry it's late. Alex, it's just a present. No thanks.
No thanks. Well, it was nice to have almost met you, Gabrielle.
Gabby.
Gabby? It's a shame you don't keep a higher class of company.
Don't even think about it.
Think about what?
Going anywhere near her. I'll rip your heart out. I mean it.
It looks like it's your heart she's not so fond of.
You were warned. Let's go.
I thought you said the target was Romanov's.
This is research.
Research?
Oh, wow.
They're absolutely stunning.
They are. Between 1885 and 1916, Fabergé produced 50 of these Easter eggs for the Empress and her daughter-in-law, the Tsarina Alexandra.
Should I take notes? Would there be a quiz?
No quiz, but there will be a test.
Okay. The Fabergés are all made of precious metals and fine jewels. Every one a unique masterpiece.
Indeed.
Most are on display in the Kremlin. The rest in private collections, museums, or lost.
In this case, at Romanov's.
Who is your buyer?
You don't want to know.
Oh, I'm stealing $40 million worth of eggs, so I want to know. I also want to know why these particular eggs are even worth $40 million.
Because no one knows they exist.
Oh, the so-called mystery eggs?
Mm-hmm.
I've heard rumors, and I thought it was just a myth.
Last year, they turned up at Romanov's.
So how did you know this?
I was partnered with a man named Viktor Korolenko, Alex's father. He was in tight with the Russians. What they knew, he knew.
So why aren't you pulling this job with him?
Let's just say he's no longer around. Leave it at that. He's gone. You're here. Now we just have to deliver.
Ripley.
Hmm?
Why? Why risk your freedom at all? This will not be anything close to easy. You are not in jail at the present. Are you not comfortable?
I'm never comfortable. Some people were born to compose music. Others to split the atom. I was born to steal shit. Hold out your hand.
My hand?
That coin was given to me by Viktor when we became partners. The coin represents a Russian phrase, Vovorovsky Mir, loosely translated, Thieves' World. Viktor belonged to it.
Now, you belong to it.
You misunderstand. Ripley is just business. This is
stalking?
Well, if you had given me your number, I would have called first.
Those are two very flawed assumptions.
Do you have a vase? I just took these from a roadside shrine, and I think they need some water. May I use that thing over there?
No. Yeah.
You know, I noticed this Russian nightclub down the block, the Riga Rose or something like that. Why don't we meet there after work?
I'm busy.
I'll wait.
I won't show.
I'll take my chances.
Nice Vidania, Alexander.
Research, Keith Ripley.
93, the Brooklyn Museum. 94, the Diamond District Warehouse. And then in 95...
I'm very familiar with Ripley's life story, Michaels. In fact, I busted him twice. Both times he walked because of good lawyering.
Exactly. So I thought, why not swing for the fences? Murder one. Victor Karolenko.
You're thinking of the Bright Beach steam bath? Forget it. There was no
nobody, body. I know, but we got like a ton of forensics.
And no witnesses. Nobody there admitted to seeing a thing. I was this close to convincing Korolenko to take witness protection in exchange for giving up Ripley. But Ripley got to him first. I can't prove it.
Right, okay, I see.
Okay. No, what you don't see, Michaels, is why Ripley got involved in a small-time caper like grabbing a few diamonds off of some couriers on a subway. And neither did I, until I read the Dutch guy's statement. Those diamonds came from Romanovs.
You mean like Ripley and his new partner planning to take down Romanovs? Ah, come on, like that could ever happen. Not even Ripley could take down a place like that.
Wanna bet?
You didn't see the nightclub. You saw the flyer and the fax, and then you made an assumption.
Yeah, guilty. So I did.
Never assume anything, especially down here.
How mysterious.
What?
How mysterious. Can I buy you a drink?
I don't drink.
An only assumption.
You want to dance?
I'm willing to make a fool of myself. Why not?
Thank you.
Amina, here. Спасибо. And for him.
Thank you.
Thanks.
I thought all Russians drank.
Translation, we're a race of suicidal alcoholics.
No, I didn't mean that. No.
Actually, we are. Mm. Cheers.
Nastarovia.
Nastarovia.
Nastarovia?
Mm-hmm.
So, how is it working for the lawyer?
Huh. I'm a lawyer too, you know.
Maybe I won't say another word because everything I assume is wrong.
Well, you don't know until you try.
True.
And besides, my father warned me about being a lawyer. He told me I should try and do something honest with my life. As if he would know.
Your father and Ripley, they were close, right?
Once upon a time. I'm sure Ripley told you my father's dead. Now Ripley likes to try to take care of me, pay for stuff, that kind of thing. Of course, it's the least he can do.
Sorry, I don't mean to pry.
Yes, you do.
Now who's making assumptions?
No, Gabby. I'm not assuming a thing. You want to know about Ripley? Stay away. You son of a bitch.
Well, you drop these and I am a gentleman, bringing them back to you.
Ah.
No, 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 no. No.
I told you to leave her alone. I'm not gonna tell you again. Get dressed. I'll be downstairs.
Start a whole new trend in interior design. What is this?
What do they look like?
Police IDs.
There's a reception at Romanov tonight, honoring the NYPD. And our invitations just arrived.
Cop for a night.
And all the donuts you can eat. Meanwhile, however, I need you to go to the dry cleaners.
Well, why don't you go and pick up your dry cleaning yourself, sir?
Who said anything about picking up? You're dropping off.
Hey,
vì ông định để cho con gái tôi chết à? Nghỉ đám cưới. Alo, ông nghe chưa? Sao ông không ra? Tôi mời chị tôi đây.
Gave, как американский говорят, we had networking to do. Commissioner Rawls?
Sir.
Gentlemen?
Deputy Commissioner Morelli, such a pleasure having you here. May we give you gentlemen a grand tour?
The secrets of Romanov?
You might say so.
Thank you. We're honored.
Please.
The guards, all of SB secret police. Every door, every inch of glass, wired and alarmed. So even if a bird flies in here, they know about it.
Top copy.
Rififi.
No. The bird flew into the museum, landed on the wire, and set off the alarm in top copy.
You're a cineast.
Well, actually, I only see heist movies.
Well, the lesson to take away from the bird flying into the museum is no matter how well you planned, always be ready to improvise, because I guarantee you, something's gonna go wrong.
I'd prefer to avoid that. Mm-hmm. Now, how comprehensive is the surveillance system?
Let's take a look.
Уровень сейфа 22 часа. Проверка.
Уровень сейфа 22 часа. Проверено.
Конец. Пропуск. Пожалуйста.
Smart car for the elevator.
And all the doors.
This way, after you.
We're on.
Good to see you, old friend. Let me introduce you. Vitaly's on. Hello.
Lieutenant Weber, I presume. You know, Ripley, identity theft is a serious crime.
And quite an embarrassing one in this case.
Really?
Do you realize how ashamed I felt? Telling that nice young lady at the door that I was still a lieutenant? I mean, at my age. Or should I say your age?
I'm not amused. What are you doing here? And why did you appropriate my invitation, as if I didn't know?
I apologize for the subterfuge. I just wanted to show my friend here some of the finer things in life. Of course, if you want to arrest us for impersonating police officers, go right ahead. I'm sure my lawyer will have us out in 2 hours.
It'd be a delightful 2 hours. Get your hands down.
Then there's all that explaining you'd have to do to your superiors. Now, that would be an embarrassment. Notorious thief, gaining admittance, pretending to be you. Great police work, Weber.
We should discuss my police work when this is all over. Who's your sidekick?
Jules Desai.
Good to meet you, Jules. I love your movies. Enjoy the party, gents, while it lasts.
Do you mind telling me what that was all about?
Just a cop.
Really? No kidding. We have been made in the very place we are supposed to take down. Exactly how do you stay out of jail? Unless, of course, you and this Weber are partners trying to set me up. Are you, Ripley?
Here we go. Come on, move your damn ass. Weber has no idea what we're here for.
Of course he does.
He doesn't know when, and he doesn't know how. And no, he doesn't know about the eggs. No one does here. Best way to neutralize Weber is to fuel his obsession with busting men. He's so blinded by it, he no longer thinks like a cop. Trust me.
Give me a good reason to. Huh?
I already gave you 40 million good reasons here.
Now that you've seen what the public sees, it's time for the real treat. That is, of course, as long as you promise not to come back and rob us.
Well, I guess I won't take any notes then.
Our main vault.
Gregor, disarm the motion detectors. As you will see, even with the knowledge of our protocols, it is absolutely impregnable. The voice sensors ask our head of security, Boris Sergeyev, a random set of pre-recorded words. But this is only half the process. We also have a biometric handprint sensor. Since Mrs. Sergeyev and I are the only ones who have clearance, we must both be present to open the vault. Once I activate the biometric handprint sensor, he must activate the voice sensor. This way, neither of us can steal from the other.
Well, you better hope Mr. Sergeyev stays healthy.
Yeah. I must stay healthy as well.
Hamburger.
Hamburger.
Big Apple.
Big Apple.
The vault door automatically resets on the hour, at which point the sensors must be activated in reverse. All in all, gentlemen, best not to get locked inside.
Well, did I say it was going to be easy?
No, but you didn't say it would be impossible either.
Armored glass, it would take a half an hour to break through just one case. But I'm afraid whoever tried wouldn't even have half a second, because an ultrasonic motion detector would automatically lock him in and trigger the alarm. Containment security, gentlemen. Getting in is highly improbable, but getting out is frankly impossible.
Where does that door lead?
To our inner vault, which contains our most precious items. I'm sorry, but security prevents me from taking even this distinguished group in there. Now, we proceed back to the reception, but before we do, I'd like to once again thank you both for your generosity this last year in helping set up our business.
Thank you very much for the donation of that chopper.
You're very welcome.
Let's go. We can do this, Gabriel.
No, absolutely not. It was a pleasure. Goodbye.
Wait a minute. Wait. Nobody's going anywhere yet. Zikov finds that camera, he's going to know what it is. They'll change all the protocols.
Which part of I don't give a shit did you not understand? Let me just please, allow me.
I'm absolutely okay.
I apologize, sir.
Special agent in charge of this op. We understand you're conducting an investigation of a potential theft that you assume is going down at Romanov Jewelers.
Assume my ass. I know it's going down, and I know who's pulling it off.
Except we're asking you to call off your dogs. There are other matters that take precedence.
What could possibly take precedence over the potential theft of millions of dollars in diamonds from a company that donates tons of money and equipment to the NYPD?
Valentin? Vitaly Zhukov in the old Soviet days was the right-hand man to a party boss named Dmitry Kuzin. Kuzin set up a supposedly independent Russian diamond center in America. Romanovs. But diamonds, they're not all that he's shipping over here.
He's ripping off the Russian treasury, detective.
Gold, gems, artworks.
Gentlemen, where do you think Romanov's got the money to buy your department a helicopter and now police cars? From retail diamond sales?
So why are they doing this?
Is that a serious question? So the NYPD will leave them alone. That's their mindset. We need more time to build our mutual cases. That's why we can't have any other investigations potentially alerting Zhikov.
Lieutenant, shut it down. Gentlemen.
Commissioner.
Yeah. Just in case you think you're smarter than us, decide to continue this investigation on the down and low, forget it. This is bigger than you and your ego. You get it?
I get it.
So what did the feds have to say?
Nothing. Everything's still a go.
The first order of business is to bypass the security cameras.
If we can gain access into the surveillance system, we can replace the live feed with a continuous loop of static shots with no thieves inside. That still leaves the voice sensors, the fingerprints, the motion detectors, the meanest looking vault door I have ever seen in my life.
With spring-driven relocking bolts. If you punch out the lock, they block the traction so that you couldn't open it even if you knew the combination.
Abraham Lincoln.
Broadway.
Broadway.
30 pre-recorded words. 1 week, we got them all.
Dan McWilliams, MTA. Yes, we're going to be doing some maintenance work in the subway adjacent to your basement next week. We'll be working nights and didn't want the drilling and water all to alarm you.
Place an ultrasonic transducer here, broadcasting at the exact operating frequency of the transmitter, and it bounces back the frequency to the unit, at least in theory.
Have you ever used an ultrasonic transducer?
Nope.
Can you get an ultrasonic transducer?
I can get anything, my friend.
Can you get past a keypad?
It is, as always, a question of time. One tumbler at a time. It is tight, but possible.
You.
Yeah. Me.
What's so funny?
I hate Chinese food. I absolutely, unequivocally, irrevocably loathe Chinese food. No, Leonard, my boss, is addicted to Chinese food. I can't even stand the smell.
Another completely wrong assumption.
No. It's not completely wrong. What? You stole this.
Yes, I did.
Didn't you?
Yes. That's what I do.
Thank you.
bracelet. I cannot return it.
No. I like it.
So, what could possibly be a problem?
You?
What?
Me?
Well, I thought that part was not a problem.
And Ripley?
That part is a problem.
Yours and Ripley's is a world I just can't trust.
How did your father die?
By gunshot.
Who did it?
He had gambling debts to a Russian gangster named Nikita Petrovich.
Nikita wants his money.
Ask him.
This concept of Vorovsky...
Vorovsky Mir, yes. I'm familiar with it.
Yeah, where one is responsible for the deaths of another one. Why would they kill your father and let Ripley live?
Because Ripley has, I don't know, how do you want me to put this, earning power. Gabby, I don't want to go to any more funerals. I want to be with you. But I can't promise you that, and you can't promise me a thing, so maybe we shouldn't even try.
Oh,
get in. I know you don't want to. I know you don't mean to, but you will hurt her. She doesn't need any more of that.
None of which you had anything to do with. Am I right?
That's something you want to ask me?
Yes. Why is Victor dead? And you're still walking around?
I'm sure Alex told you that Victor was in deep to a man named Nikita Petrovich. What she didn't know was Nikki was ready to forgive the debt if Victor pulled a job. This job.
Victor backed out.
He was trying to protect Alex. Made a deal with Weber. He's going to drop a dime on Nikki.
And you?
And me. Weber offered Victor witness protection. He and Alex, but Alex didn't want to go. Victor didn't want to go without her, so he bought a bullet instead.
So then why is this still your problem? Why don't you just leave?
Don't make a deal with Nikita Petrovich and then walk away. It's no statute of limitations. Nikki wants those eggs. Victor's share would have paid off his debt. Victor and I were partners. He was responsible for me. So now I'm responsible for him and his debt.
Bullshit. Victor is dead. Just walk away.
That's not an option.
Oh, wow, this is just...
Look. We do the job. Nikki gets his cut. I take a small chunk, nowhere near commensurate with my risk. And you clear a cool 20 million.
I don't know. It's just...
Look, either we pull this job off flawlessly, or you call Weber and you ask for witness protection, which isn't a choice at all, because Nikki will find you and he will kill you. Doesn't matter where you go or how long it takes. That's an unalterable fact.
Well,
then we steal the fucking eggs. No?
Yes.
Oh, shit. All right, we are working on it. I'm a cooler, so back off, please. Thank you.
I think he called us a name.
We do not like to be insulted.
All right.
Ah.
Do you know the significance of this coin?
Yeah.
Then you must know, by the mere fact that you have it in your possession, I cannot assume the two of you will not attempt to double-cross me.
Nobody's gonna try to double-cross you, Nicky. I've been trying to... Alex, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, well, we're all sorry, aren't we?
There's no reason for you to bring her here.
The fact that you give that coin to him tells me there are many reasons, but only one I care about.
Why would we try to betray you?
Well, Ripley, in your case, perhaps a misguided sense of revenge. Yes, perhaps simply greed. It doesn't matter. I will not take the chance on the two of you taking what is rightfully mine and selling it to the highest bidder.
Please, excuse me, Mr. Petrovich. Would you please think? What is it written that these eggs are yours?
Because they belong to my family. Because my great-grandfather made them. Yes, Ripley. Evgeny Petrovich made them. Zhenya. He made the 1917 mystery eggs. I will have those eggs. And you will get them for me. That's why I bring Alexandra here. To keep me company while you do what you need to do. Anyone try to follow us, she dies. If there are police, she dies. If I don't get what I want, she dies. Go. There is a subway, not far.
Damn you, Gabriel. I told you not to get her involved.
You told me? You told me? You and her father got her involved even before she was born. God damn it. We go tomorrow.
Слышу шум, постоянный шум.
Какой шум?
Неужели ты не слышишь?
Нет.
Разрешение разузнать.
Здесь.
Подожди.
Грегор, шума не слышен. Из МТА позвонил кто-то.
Что ты слышишь? Это шум ремонта поддержки метро.
Шум ремонта?
Да, метро. Будь на своем
посту. Конец.
Уровень шефа, конец.
How much time?
Just over 3 minutes until the truck's $200 check.
Уровень сейфа 22 часа проверено.
Конец.
Синтейка подвал.
Это не NTA.
По протоколу Грегор обязан проверить это.
Уровень сейфа, ответьте.
Уровень сейфа, что?
Проверите наверняка, получила сигнализация в Кире.
Хорошо, я пошел.
Выключу сигнализацию.
Конец.
Скажи ему, я скажу.
Все чисто.
Конец.
Smart card. Let's go.
Он не торопится. Становится довольно-таки досадно.
Что это такое?
Порно?
Днем рождения, Артур.
Это не мое день рождения.
Разве не сегодня?
Хо-хо-хо-хо-хо.
Кто-то принес торт ко дню рождения, Артур.
Это не мое день рождения.
Моя ошибка. Я подумал, что это было 23-го.
Черт, я забыл радиостанцию в сутерене. Разрешение вернуться.
Только поскорее, Григор. Это не смешно.
Хороший тор.
Чаще нужно иметь день рождения.
Да, чаще.
Распутин.
Распутин.
17.
17.
Norway.
Norway.
T. Gluttony. T. Gluttony.
Fuck. Wants to know if I'm hungry. Are you?
T. Gluttony. T. Gluttony.
Нет. It's working. Let's go.
Now, Hootie and Michaels have me to set the staging area.
Yes, sir.
Now it's my turn.
We're good.
Easy.
You're on.
All right. Okay, a little more.
Ready?
Come on, a little more. Come on, more. Okay, right there. All right.
Your time.
One. No. Two. No. Three. What are you doing?
Improvising.
See if you can move these boxes. What are you doing?
Give me the box.
do this.
Give me the box.
What, you want more money? Hell, man, look around you. Take what you want.
Shut up and give me the box.
What about Alex? Nikki will kill her, you know that.
I will ask you one more time.
Why are you doing this?
I'm a cop. In Miami for the last 10 years. Whoever requested me, just for you.
So you're a cop. You want to arrest me? Go ahead. Where am I going to go? But in 1 minute, that vault door's going to lock. And we'll be stuck in here. And Alex is going to be dead. I can't believe you're such a contemptible human being that you would use her like that and then just kill him. Because you might as well be pulling the trigger yourself. Simply to bag the great Keith Ripley. You sorry, sick motherfucker. You got 30 seconds.
How do I find Nikki?
Phone number in my pocket.
Give it to me. And the ex. Do you want her alive or not?
Do you? Ten seconds.
I'm sorry.
Сейф, ответьте. Уровень сейфа, ответьте. Грегор. Богдан, проверь лифт сразу.
Closet. Move! 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 Move out of there! Now! Move! Come on! Tell them to put their weapons down! Now! Now!
Okay! Fine!
Put them down! Now!
Оружие к земле!
Kick them! Now!
What do you want?
You let me out the front door so I can rejoin my unit. They have the building surrounded. Meantime, you go downstairs, you find your thief and your comrade. You understand?
That door is alarmed. I can't just open it.
You have some problem. Solve it! Do not make me shoot this man, please.
Yeah? Everyone is police tonight.
Hey, I have what you want. No, it's just me.
The police are good. I'm going to be inside.
So, you're here.
Can we talk? I have a proposition for you.
Where is she?
Do not move. He has a gun behind the box. Bad boy.
Give me the box. And give under your weapon, please. We'll not wish trouble here.
No. You don't understand. You let her go, then I'll give you the box. You see, if I fire through this box, which I have no problem doing whatsoever, Nikki is not gonna be very happy. Then we are all expendable. If you actually understand the meaning of that word.
Open the box.
Lower the gun. Lower the gun. Lower it.
Okay.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm just lovely, thanks.
You go. Give him the box.
Get in.
Why?
Nikki wants to see you.
Give me your weapon.
We're fine, right?
Where do you get off detaining us?
My apologies, Lieutenant Weber. My security were understandably confused. Please go with Mr. Segev down to the vault. We have what you want. Please.
Where's the other one?
Nobody else. Just him.
Where the hell's my man?
Lieutenant, your personal life, none of my business.
I apologize for bringing you here, but I had to be sure the eggs were genuine before I let you go.
Your lack of trust is really depressing, Mr. Petrovich.
I'm a man of my word. She should be with her godfather now.
Let's see. Do you mind?
Sure, cool.
Yeah.
Hello?
Hey, where are you?
I'm at the jail. I had to see him.
How is he?
Well, how do you think he is?
I had no choice, Alex.
No one had a choice.
Remember? I told you neither one of us could promise a thing.
Listen, promises blow away in the wind. Feelings are real. And I need to know where the feelings lies to.
Listen. What I mean is,
are we real?
I gotta go, Gabriel. Good night.
Hold.
Are you satisfied? Did you see them?
Actually, we were in a hurry.
Look.
They are simply wood.
Simply wood. It was 1917, Gabriel. Russia. People were starving. There were no jewels. No diamonds left. No hope. Yet Tsarina Alexandra had to have her eggs. Perhaps you understand why we had the revolution. People needed to believe in something. Take him home. Gabriel. I know what they say about me, but I'm not a killer. Merely a humble immigrant. Probably much like you.
I don't think so, Mr. Petrovich. You're not like me at all.
Excellent. Thanks. We got Petrovich. Snitch called it in. After all this time looking for him, you know where he was?
I'm sure you'll tell us.
He was sitting on the boardwalk watching the sun come up. He's coming in now. I'll be right back.
Yeah. What I didn't count on was that a so-called professional would be manipulated by a chick. What kind of cops they make down there in Miami?
Good ones, Weber. Good ones.
I don't get it. All these years in that world, how do you let an asset use you?
Sometimes things change.
Things change? Like, which side am I on? Change? Ripley, what is he, your best friend now?
Huh? Actually, a better friend than you.
Ah, I get it. I'm the asshole. You gonna tell me what a good guy he is? Or how he got caught up in a situation he couldn't control? Or how the sins of the father shouldn't rest on the daughter? Give me something better than things change!
All I can give you is the truth.
Ah, fuck it. Go back to Miami, Martine. When your superiors get my report, you'd be lucky if you have a job.
We'll see.
Hey, say anything you want about Ripley, but nothing changes the fact that I finally got him. And when he leaves prison, he'll be leaving in a pine box.
Let's go see Mr. Petrovich.
That's not Nicky Petrovich.
What?
Not him.
Look, man, organized crime confirmed it. That's Nicky Petrovich.
Well, I don't care. That's not him. I was there, remember?
There's no case here.
What are you talking about? Of course there's a case.
Do you really think I'm gonna put him on the stand? An undercover Miami cop who may or may not be legit? No offense.
Nantic.
A cop who's the centerpiece of a botched undercover operation that was officially ordered stopped. I'm not going to embarrass the Bureau, much less your department, which accepted tons of money and equipment from the Russian mafia.
What about Romanovs? What about the goddamn stolen treasures of Russia?
What about it, Weber?
When Zhukov found Ripley in the vault, he had everything cleared out before you could get in.
I have a proposition for you. There's no way Romanovs would press charges against Ripley.
Because they can never admit that the eggs or anything else ever existed.
So we can't even prove that Detective Martine and Ripley stole even a goddamn dime.
You must have mug shots. Russian mafia, known associate, something.
Him. That's Nicky Petrovich.
Detective Martine?
Yeah.
That's Viktor Korolenko. Presumed dead.
We just never found the body.
You never will, Lieutenant.
Got him in front of a judge on an expedited bail hearing.
And then he just walks.
Who was it?
Who's what?
The lawyer.
Who the fuck do you think? Alex. Korolenko.
You can't promise me a thing, so maybe we shouldn't even try.
Nikki Petrovich is the one Zykov is funneling the contraband through.
Thank you, but Zykov and Petrovich
have gone to ground.
Check out a disco
called
Rio Rose.
Ah, so you're familiar with the territory?
Well, I am a cop, remember?
Never forgot it for a second.
When did you know?
I knew you were coming up from Miami before you did, Garvey. See, Weber and I...
Well, let's just say we share the same sources. Only I pay better.
Sir, we're good to go.
So, why the help, Ripley?
I mean, feeling guilty?
Guilt's not even in my vocabulary. I was just hoping you'd see things differently. Together, you and I could do anything.
Yeah, I believe we did.
I'll get in touch later on if you're interested. Meanwhile, I've got to keep an appointment with a man who's going to pay very dearly for something he's got to keep locked in his basement just to say it's his. Good hunting, Gabi.
Wait.
Let me talk to her, just for a second.
That's it.
What makes you think she's going anywhere? She didn't commit any crime. She just lied to someone who was lying to her. You be good.
I'll try, Cookies. Although, I suspect my legal career just ended.
Thank God.
We'll be right back.
You come in here every night. And every night I tell you, I don't know shit from this Petrovich. Zhukov. He's a nice good, my friend. You know what I think? I think you need to check out the action and get your ass laid. You know what I'm saying, dude? Find yourself a chick.
Водка чистая и закуска моему другу.
Закуска?
Russian hors d'oeuvres to coat the stomach.
You my stomach make coating?
I hope so.
I thought you didn't drink.
You thought a lot of things. But I believe I mentioned something about making assumptions.
Maybe there's a concept we should get rid of. Immediately. My name is Gabriel Martin. I'm from Miami. I was actually looking for a lawyer, but the office was closed. So I came here.
Okay. My name is Alexandra Korolenko, and I come from St. Petersburg by way of Little Odessa. And I love to dance. So I came here tonight. Do you want to dance with me?
Yeah. I'm willing to make a fool of myself.
Me too.
Alex.
Yeah?
That night when I called you from Coney Island, you never answered my question.
Which one?
I want to know. Was it all lies?
Not the part that matters.
That was real. That was real, finally.